each other.
Yeah, yeah.
So if you would, let's introduce ourselves and then we'll do that, okay? So I'm Jerry Fitterman, and I happen to be the chair now, but that's just for now. It's not a lifetime. Yes, thank you. It's, I've been in Elliott since 2009. I love living here. And, your turn.
Matt Gardner, vice chair.
Vice chair.
I'm Brad Baker. I've been in the neighborhood like 9 months.
Welcome.
I'm Sue Stringer, and I've lived in the neighborhood 5.5 years, and been more about 3.5 years, and I'm a newsletter editor. So I live on the 7th, the very edge, right across the street from Burlington. So I get to see what happens in that neighborhood. Ours is always a little cleaner than ours, so we'd say it's very nice.
Really?
Oh, nice.
I'm Jonathan Conkle. I actually live really close to her. I'm in the townhouses behind Knight. I've lived in Elliott for about 9 months. I have just joined as vice chair of the Land Use and Transportation Committee. I've been coming to land use meetings since last spring, I guess. I've just moved back to Portland last spring from Seattle, but I used to live in Buckman, Portland up there.
My name's Robert West. I go by Bob, and I'm a videographer. I live in the King neighborhood.
I'm Ann Casper. I bought my house in Sacramento in 1998, and I was on this board in 1999 to 2003, I believe. There was a woman on my street, Hattie, and she was the matriarch, and she got us all to come. So when you have matriarchs, that happens. She also got the drugs off of Sacramento Street. That was on Channel 8 at that time. I remember seeing that. And so my street's changed a lot, and I'm here to talk about it today.
Right. Patricia Montgomery, call me Pat. I'm part of the St. Philip Church. Huh. I live in the neighborhood 4 blocks away. Been here since 1988. Yeah, stopped counting a long time ago. Lots of changes in the neighborhood, and that's why I'm part of the board, and glad we got all these new faces joining us. So.
I'm Jimmy Wilson. I got a business in the Elliott neighborhood. Been in Portland all my life. That's some years, so I'm just seeing what I can get shopping and see what we can do to help people get together and make changes as needed, keep the community happy and safe. I just like a happy place, that's all.
Well, I'm Jim Halaba. I am the treasurer for Elliott Neighborhood Association. I've been on the board for about 10 years, and I work with Cascade Behavioral Health here that owns property where we have a building at the point where we're building 52 housing kind of in the Hollywood district, not far from here.
My name is Monica Choi Salazar, and I'm the recorder. I've been in the neighborhood in May, but I've been working in the neighborhood for 4 years.
My name is Anna Daggett, and I've been in the area for about a year and a half, and in Portland for 7, and right in New Zealand, and a new member of the board.
I'm part of Gossip.
Different name.
Yeah, okay. Which was
get to see faces we haven't seen.
And she's full of energy too.
Yeah.
So I would like you to turn to your neighbor and talk about why you like Elliott the way it is now. What's good about Elliott for you?
What do you like in life?
My experience is that the world is still very different from all those of us in Orlando, and some of us are still there. And it's still the same with our
community. Are you on
Essos? I'm on, yes.
Okay, well, they got that big apartment complex.
A many apartment complex. We have four apartment units. Low income.
I'm trying to want to still stay here, but I'm getting concerned about the parking. But I still love the neighborhood.
Right.
I've been here a long time. This church is my home. You know, I'm feeding the homeless and houses. We actually did not pass her, but we just got a lady that was on the other side of me. She's going to become our pastor, and then we're just in the bell.
Right.
And she will be starting the first class. So we're excited. We've been through two classes in 3 years. We've been through this.
You scare me.
Well, you know what? No, it's an old historic African American church, so it's hard to come in and work with some of the people.
How about you?
Well, we call it that apartment. It's like our stepping room. It's got a need. I think that's where how this community got this.
stay here, and when they made the changes of the taxes.
So the first business, before we do the minutes were set out, there's several here, but the board has already had them on email, and then we'll look at those after we do our new business according to the agenda, which is guests. We have two guests today, and...
Are you talking today? You're not talking?
Huh?
Are you talking today as well?
I'm just on the board.
Okay.
We have two guests, and so wanna go first?
I'm the only one speaking today, because Bob's here with me. Bob's an old friend. He does video. I've been doing TV shows for years, and right now, Open Signal, we can't check out videos. And when I speak, I like my neighbors to see what I'm saying, because they need to know what I'm saying out there. And also, when I spoke in front of City Hall in September, my friend nicely videotaped that, and they can see, because they won't come to these kinds of meetings. They won't go to City Hall, they won't go to the, like my neighbors tonight, they won't come here. I'm just telling you. So what I do is I ask Bob to come here tonight. Can you film me?
Yeah.
Okay. to film me, because I want my neighbors, not that close. Bob. Get some shots of other people. I know, I didn't make makeup all tonight.
I've been filming.
You been filming us?
So can we just not, we'll just take care of that film and take care, you know,
we'll just talk about it.
Okay. Yeah. So my name is Ann Casper, and I'm here as a representative of Sacramento Street. And I'm talking today about Sacramento Street. There's all kinds of Sacramento Street in Elliott, but I'm talking about the one from, I have 5 minutes, right?
Yes.
Okay, I'm just watching the time. So, from Northeast 7th until MLK, and at the end of our block is right now Ox, which has been a bunch of different restaurants, but now it's Ox, and then we got Billy Ray's over there, the Dive, the Great, they still have games there, and we got, this is a traffic circle, so you go around here, and so they're going to be putting in these things called bioswells. I believe they spoke to you last time, but they didn't tell us you were coming. So we didn't come to the meeting because we didn't know they were coming to the neighborhood association meeting. And we've been discussing with them for about a year and a half with Mr. Fish's office, with the Bureau of Environmental Services, with all kinds of things. My neighbors, not just me, it's a bunch of neighbors writing emails saying, hey, it's hard on Sacramento Street to find parking as it is between 7th and 1K. And I'll tell you what, we are not the normal blocks. Because, and I'll tell you why, we have a bunch of apartment complexes. I'm sorry I don't have all the numbers here tonight, but I do have all the numbers. And there's there, and here, and here. So we actually are a very unusual neighborhood, which is so cool because we have loads of apartments. And I love my street because it's full of immigrants and refugees. And me, and some of the other old people. I think. There's only one guy who's been there longer than me, and it's just a really special street. And they're mainly, right now, from Eritrea, Ethiopia, and Somalia. We used to have some Mexicans and some others because of them. So these are all apartments, and we're talking, I think, 300 units. Many of them are taxi drivers, so they actually park their taxis and they on the street, and they trade off. So we're losing parking that way because we have a bunch of taxi drivers there. As well as other kind of various things. And so these are houses. So we're talking 300 people. And then at the end of the block, I don't know if you ever see the big party in August. They have a big block party. You know, hundreds of people come. VOA. So you have about 54 people living there, plus their relatives and their girlfriends and their children. They come visit and they park here, right? And also, you have the at least 40 people who work there who also park on the street. And then they're going to be building a 16 new apartment complex without parking at the end of the block. And also, we just, instead of two houses, they built these new 8 units here, which my neighbors aren't going to welcome them, but they're parking. So I've lived there for 20 years. I used to be able to park in front of my house up until
couple of years ago. And I've been a neighbor so long, I've had 3 cars stolen from my house. So right now, because I can't park on my street, we come out 7 o'clock at night,